Welcome to this video. I am Dr. R.K. Shukla, Department of Physics, University of Lucknow. Today, I am discussing about the eye pattern technique using in communication. The eye pattern is used to study the performance of optical communication link. Earlier, this technique is used in wire system, and now this technique is applied to optical data link. It is very useful method for assessing the data handling ability of a digital transmission system. The eye pattern measurement are made in the time domain, means the signal value is known for all real numbers for the case of continuous line, and allow the effect of waveform distortion to be shown on oscilloscope. The shape of this pattern resembles with the shape of human eye, hence it is known as the eye pattern or eye diagram. Let us see in next slide. Eye pattern is a practical way to study the inter-symbol interference. In short, it is known as ISI, and its effect on a pulse code modulation or data communication system. The inter-symbol interference is a form of distortion of a signal in which one symbol interferes with the subsequent symbol. We see in this figure the data symbol 1 is represented by this one, and 0 is represented by this, and 1 is represented by this symbol, and 1 is represented by this symbol. If we input these type of signal after some distance, the symbol change its shape and it's look like this, and after traveling some distance these pulses are intermixing to each other. So these area are known as inter-symbol interference. This effect, unwanted phenomena, as the previous symbol have similar effect as noise, thus making the communication less reliable, because we are not distinguish the pattern incident in the input side and we observe output side not the same pattern as input. So this effect makes unreliable communication. And this inter-symbol interference is usually caused by multi-path propagation or the inherent non-linear frequency response of a channel or band-limited channel, causing successive symbol to blur. Blur means less distinct. This is mixing together. The presence of ISI in the system introduces errors in the decision device at the receiver output. Therefore, in the design of transmitting and receiving filters, the objective is to minimize the effect of inter-symbol interference and thereby deliver the digital data to its destination with the smallest error rate possible. How we get the eye pattern? The eye pattern is obtained on the CRO by applying the received data signal to vertical deflection plate of CRO and the word pseudo-random bit pattern generator is used for bit at the transmission symbol at a data rate at 1 by TV to the horizontal plate X. Now we consider the 3-bit long non-return to zero coding combination as the decimal value of zero represented by 3-bit long energized is 000 and 1 is represented by 001, 2 represented by 010, 3 represented by 011, 4 represented by 100, 5 represented by 101, 6 represented by 110 and 7 represented by 111. So in the 3-bit binary number, we represent decimal number 0 to 7 in this way. Now we make a pulse form of all this 3-bit number. When the 3-bit number pattern is 000, this means this is the line represent the 000, and the middle portion is the threshold region, and upper region is the 1 label and lower region is the 0 label. Now we represent the value of 001. So in the first two column, the value is 00, and third column represent 1. So the pulse is increasing. And similarly, we represent 010 by this, and 010 represented by this figure, and 100 represented by this figure, 101 represented by this figure, 110 represented by this figure, and 111 represented by this. So these 8 patterns are observed in CRO if we make 000 to 111 binary bits. Now we superimpose all these patterns to in a single block, we obtain the I pattern. Some of the key features of this pattern include the opening and width of the I. Let us see in further slide. The 20 to 80% rise and fall time, overshoot on logic 1s and 0s values, undershoot on logic 0 values, jitter in the I pattern. What is mean by jitter? Jitter is when high speed digital signal are transmitted, the impairment introduced at various stages lead to timing error. One such timing error is jitter, which results from the misalignment of rise and fall time. Jitter occurs when rising or falling edges occur at times that differ from the ideal time. So we get the jitter. Some edges occur early or some occur late. So there is a difference between time. So this jitter is known as timing jitter. The deviation of the digital signal as a result of reflection, inter-symbol interference, crosstalk, process voltage temperature variation, and other factor amount to jitter. And this is the I pattern observed in CRO. System performance information obtained from the I pattern, the following information regarding the signal amplitude distortion. This is the signal. Timing jitter. This is the timing jitter. System rise time can be derived from the I pattern. When we observe the time at 20% to 80%, the difference between the time at 20% to 80% is known as the rise time. And similarly, when 80% amplitude reduces to 20%, then this time is known as the fall time. This is the simplified I diagram. A great deal of system performance can be deduced from the I pattern displays. To interpret the I pattern, consider figure 6. This is figure 6, earlier we discussed it, and simplified drawing shown in figure 7. The following information regarding the signal amplitude distortion, timing jitter, and system rise time can be derived by using this figure. The width of I opening, this is the width of eye opening, defines the time interval over which the received signal can be sampled. So we can choose any time between this region for sampling without error due to interference from adjacent pulses. If we take sample between this region, then we are not able to sample in this region. The higher the opening, lower the inter-symbol interference. The best time to sample the received waveform is when the height, this is the height of eye opening, is largest. This height is reduced as result of amplitude distortion in the data signal. The vertical distance between the top of the eye opening and the maximum signal level, this is the maximum signal level, the value of maximum signal voltage is V2, and this is the of eye opening, the value of eye opening voltage is V1. So the difference between V2 minus V1, the more the eye closes, the more difficult it is distinguish between the ones and zeros in the signal. If there is a less area of eye opening, then there is a difficult to distinguish between the values of zeros and one. When the effect of inter-symbol interference is severe, the eye is completely closed. This means this area is not observed. So it is impossible to avoid error due to combined presence of inter-symbol interference and noise in the system. So the eye opening is large, then we distinguish the signal at the receiver end. Noise margin. The noise margin is the percentage ratio of the peak signal voltage V1 for an alternating bit sequence to the maximum signal voltage V2 as measured from the threshold region. This is the threshold level. Noise margin in percent equal to V1 upon V2 into 100%. The height of eye opening at a specified sampling time defines the margin over noise or immunity to noise. Closing of the eye is a measure of degradation in receiver performance. This is the noise margin region. So we have in this value to tolerate the noise. The sensitivity of the system to the timing error is determined by the rate of closure of the eye as the sampling rate is varied. This is the sensitivity. The slope of this line gives the sensitivity in timing error. The slope of the eye pattern determines the sensitivity of the system to timing error. The possibility of timing errors increases as the slope becomes more horizontal. This means the angle between this is less, the timing error is increases, and this line goes to parallel of this threshold line. Timing jitter, also referred to as eye jitter, edge jitter, or phase distortion, in an optical fiber system arises from noise in the receiver and pulse distortion in the optical fiber. Pulse distortion means inter-symbol interference. If the signal is sampled in the middle of the time interval, that is midway between the times when the signal crosses the threshold level, then the amount of distortion, this is the amount of distortion, delta T, at the threshold level indicate the amount of jitter. This gives the amount of jitter in timing. And it is given by delta T upon TB into 100%. The TB is the bit interval. This is the timing jitter, measure of jitter in time scale. Because in x axis time scale and y axis is the amplitude scale. Traditionally, the rise time is defined as the time interval between the points where the rising edge of the signal reaches 10% of its final amplitude to the time where it reaches 90% of its final amplitude. In this figure, the 10% of the maximum value of the signal, the time is T1, and the 90% at this, the time is T2. The difference between T2 minus T1 is the rise time. Similarly, the time 90% T3 and the 10% fall of maximum height is T4, then the difference between T4 minus T3 gives the fall time. But in the optical fiber communication, we observe at 20% and 80% threshold point are normally measured. So to convert from the 20% to 80% rise time to a 10% to 90% rise time, the relation are given by T 10 to 90 equal to 1.25 into T 20 minus 80. Similarly, we can determine the fall time. The size of the eye, this is the size of the eye, gives idea of bit period, and delta T is the distortion in bit period. Now, rise time is less. It gives better performance, and shape of the eye pattern will be given in this. Here, the angle is greater, so sensitivity is large. Similarly, if rise time is large, then noise margin is less and gives poor performance. The shape of the eye pattern will be given as there is vertical height is less in comparison to this. So this gives poor performance and this gives better performance in terms of rise time. Any non-linearity of the channel transverse characteristics will create an asymmetry in the eye pattern if a purely random data stream is passed through a purely linear system. All the eye opening will be identical and symmetrical. So the eye pattern is must to observe before installing the optical communication. Because if we are not determined the different parameter through eye diagram, then the optical communication is not faithful in the practice. Thank you.